Canada's mandatory long-form census was abolished by the Harper government in 2010. The low response rate and new methodology of 2011's National Household Survey made it incompatible with previous mandatory long-form censuses. Canada's two most senior statisticians claimed that the 2011's voluntary census had resulted in useless data. The long-form census is used in a variety of areas, including healthcare, education, and transportation planning. Until 2010, it was sent to 1 in 5 Canadians, producing data from a non-biased sample of the population and serving as an important planning tool in Canada. Good data collection is necessary for good governance, policy formulation, and the effective dispersal of public funds. The elimination of the mandatory long-form census has led to the loss of policy-relevant, objective, and reliable data about the state of Canadian society. Open data is defined as structured data that is machine-readable, freely shared, used, and built on without restrictions. In March 2011, the Government of Canada launched an open data portal. As part of this effort, data produced, collected, and used by departments and agencies across the federal government became available for everyone. In addition to the main portal site, other federal department sites include geospatial databases that could be vastly used for land use and transportation planning purposes. Data is Canada's new natural resource. The sky is the limit in terms of what we can do with this material. Tony Clements. In his mandate letter to the Minister of Innovation, Science and Economic Development, Justin Trudeau asked for restoring the long-form census and updating legislation governing Statistics Canada to reinforce the institution's independence and improving the quality of publicly available data in Canada. Many have viewed the Liberals' decision to reinstate the long-form census as the first step of committing to an open and fair government. Spokesperson of Metrolinx, Toronto's transit agency, said that the organization is excited for the return of the long-form census, which she called the gold standard that all other data sources are compared to. Recommendations. 1. Although data produced from long-form census is extremely valuable, similar to many other countries, Canada can gradually move away from traditional data gathering techniques towards the data collection on a broader scale to get the information that is necessary for land use and transportation planning. 2. Provide incentives and create data management specific educational programs to produce workers with data management skills while focusing on bringing together data science and urban planning. 3. Currently, open provinces only include Ontario, Quebec, Newfoundland, Alberta, and BC. Some data, such as property taxes, is not available for all municipalities. We recommend creating a national standard for open data to ensure land use and transportation planners have an equal opportunity in creating healthy, efficient, and equitable cities across Canada.